So, Mimir, why did Frey spin your face?
No. Speak of Baldur. He claims nothing harms him.
Aye, Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
Boasting of a god. Everyone has a weakness.
Not him, I'm afraid. Baldur is blessed with invulnerability to all threats, physical or magical.
You just said that, Mimir.
Did I?
What is the source of this power?
Well, as I recall, it involved, a spell?
Mimir?
Parts of my brain must still be coming back to life. Just need a moment to finish waking up.
I hope he's not broken. Mimir, we're in the lake.
Perfect. Dock us near the bridge.
Ed, how do we speak to the serpent?
There's a horn on a platform at the middle point of the bridge. Take me to it.
Finally! That horn!
Good. Now put my lips to the horn. That statue made in honor of Thor. And seeing as the world serpent absolutely abhors the fat dauber, he was probably sick of looking at it.
But doesn't that hurt?
Well, he and Thor have a bit of an unpleasant history between them. Or they will, anyway. So I guess waking up to see it was worse than the thought of lumps of solid stone passing through his gullet. You want me to ask him?
No. Our only concern is Jotunheim.
All right, wish me luck. I've still got it, lads. He remembers me. Why are you? Oh no, that's not right. Mokuno Huntunkun. Eko no Tunno Funno. The pain of your loss. He will help you. Curious.
What is it?
Oh, nothing to be concerned about.
What is he doing?
Making sure we're heading in the right direction. Listen closely now. We need two things to get us into the land of the giants. First, we need to learn the travel rune that opens realm travel to Jotunheim. Second, we need to carve that rune into the special gateway.
That one of the people we first met you?
Correct. Except the giants, in their infinite wisdom, saw to it that no ordinary chisel would do the job. Only the tip of a magical chisel opens that gate. Luckily, I know where it is, and it's not far.
He looked kind of mad for a moment there.
Now that, he thought I said you were friends of Odin. You'll forgive me. I've never spoken the ancient tongue sober.
Wait, look! The water's dropped even further. You can see more of the realm towers and statues. I even see new places to explore along the shore.
Where is this chisel?
Find me a boat, and we'll go from there.
Get to the boat. We can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
Nightmare! What awful!
Here. Boy.
Yes, sir. It's another one of those maps.
Have you made it out of Fafnir's storeroom yet?
Hey, Sindri. Have you met Mimir?
If you mean the severed head that keeps blinking at me, please, keep it away. There is no possible way that's hygienic.
Oh, that's nice. Lovely to see you too, Sindri.
Nob.
Why? Is that a piece of my braided mistletoe arrow adorning your quiver strap? Oh, a little memento of your good pal, Sindri? I'm so terribly touched.
Thank you.
wish Mom were here.
Thrones.
Stop being coy, Head. Do you know this place or not?
Mimir, the smartest man alive. I know many things.
Well, whatever this place is, it looks important.
To who? There is little of value here.
Just make sure you watch each other's backs in the storeroom. Wouldn't want to lose my loyal customers.
Way to the chisel.
Keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won. But the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses. And for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. But a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. Took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
Gurvik.
You were taken from this realm too early. You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy,
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death, if only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake. Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Good. The special chisel is ahead past this gate.
Ready yourself!
Maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
look while we... Look if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand. This chisel we seek. What is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Famu. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, the quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, bonk, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Famur chased after his son, but in his emotional state soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamyr fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. But truth is, the sweaty ball bag just got lucky.
Dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Are we doing this?
One, yes. A very, very giant chisel. Magically sealed, I'm afraid.
Big crystal on the giant's ring was promising. Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Trick, lad.
Thanks. Good idea. What happened to the survivors?
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
This is locked up good. Way.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Hostiles. Should we attack? And I'll find my crystal.
Wolver behind you!
Well, here's the base for the crystal we saw, but how do we get it down? Hey, how did the world treat that? That's handy.
Thank you.
Atreus, here.
Yes, father.
Can you read it?
To Njord, we offer back the sea's bounty.
Ah, yes. It was believed that Njord calmed the winds and seas for the fishermen. For that, they loved him and worshipped him here.
Maybe we can go this way. How are we getting down there?
I have a plan.
You do?
Do not act so surprised.
Oh, no offense, brother, but I don't even think Thor with Mjolnir in hand could get through that much ice.
Then Thor is a fool.
This should be entertaining.
Boy.
Ready.
Go!
Wow, that was something at the fight. Here, catch. Well, that was a waste of a perfectly good hour.
How were you not seen? There is nowhere here to hide.
Oh, that. It's a little trick my people can pull. A special way of not being seen.
You can be invisible?
More like I can step into the realm between realms. And your mind doesn't understand what it's seeing, so it sees nothing at all. That's how we avoid ever having to actually use the weapons we craft. It doesn't seem to work on dragons, though.
Your brother wanted to know if you're getting enough to eat. I guess I could tell him you are.
Brock was asking about me?
Was there meat on his breath?
You let him touch this again. Come on, then.
So that's how Brock was in the temple right after the water drop. He stepped between realms.
Okay, now, shush. I need complete silence for this. There you go. Let's do it! For your enemies. Oh, we can't forget you. Ah, what more do you need? Yes, dear boy? Something else for you, then.
Was there more to...
Discuss.
So, this plan of yours.
Can you guess it?
Knowing you, it doesn't involve standing around here.
Correct.
But how do we move forward? Boy, Farmer really liked jewelry, didn't he? Even braided his beard with it.
I happen to think he looks dashing. You know, for a snow-covered corpse.
Go!
right here!
We heading into that building?
Yes.
You think there's something inside that'll help us break the ice and get to the temple tip?
No.
I'll keep thinking.
Ready yourself, boy!
Done.
Before?
I came here on a diplomatic mission once, trying to broker a peace between Asgard and Vanaheim. That war, so many lives lost. What I didn't know was Thor had already gone on a killing spree of giants.
What did the giants have to do with the war between the gods?
Nothing at all, lad. That's the tragedy of it. They took no side in that madness. But Odin's paranoia is surpassed only by Thor's lust for blood.
And the rescue!
another crystal. Just give the word. Most of it.
Well, a stealthy plan it is not.
Now we must free the other strap.
We do? Going up, and what we need is all the way down there.
Think.
Well, the chisel tip is under thick layers of ice, so melting it won't work.
Correct.
And there weren't any shattered crystals nearby for me to shoot, so that's not an option.
Correct.
That just leaves smashing the ice. We need something ridiculously heavy to... Oh, I get it now.
Good.
Turn the hammer so it lands near the chisel tip.
Not possible. We cut it free, write it down, and figure out what comes next after.
So your plan involves a whole bunch of luck, then?
You are welcome to suggest a different one. Tight.
This plan seems ill-advised.
Quiet head.
Jump!
I fell a little ways. There's a sand bowl, but how do we get to it?
We cannot. Here, boy. What does it say?
When time itself is disarrayed, the forward path is retrograde. Retrograde? It's backwards?
Those symbols. The seasons?
Yeah, but the order's all jumbled. Shouldn't it be winter, spring, summer, autumn?
Why start with winter?
It's from a song Mother used to sing.
Don't I know that one? Winterlight.
Quiet, head.
Doesn't like music either. Got it.
Boy.
Var. House. Vetter. Sumar. Nuh-uh. That wasn't right.
Write it.
Vetter. Vower. Sumar. House. It didn't work, but I know that's the order in the song Mom sang.
There.
Vetter. House. Var. Sumar. Still nothing.
Boy, the order from the song again.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn.
Try that.
Vetter, Var, Sumar, House. It didn't work, but I know that's the order in the song.
There.
Vetter, Sumar, Var, House.
Retrograde, lads.
What?
Of course. The riddle. The answer is reversed. Write it. The riddle. Winter is last.
There you go, brother.
Winter, spring, summer, autumn.
Atreus, that word.
Thola. It means endure.
Try it.
Thola.
Well done, lad.
Write it again.
Thola. Horizon! The energy's lifting the platform.
Keep writing.
Thola. Thola. Thola.
Head. How is this possible?
My guess? Temporal magic. Dangerous stuff the High Vanir gods used to play around with. The ability to freeze time. Happened to be a favorite of Njord himself, in fact.
Used to? Why did they stop?
Well, turns out stopping time keeps the sun and moon from streaking across the sky. Unfortunately, it does not stop the wolves that chase them, always looking to sink their teeth in. After that, they decided it was best to leave time alone.
Writing before the floor collapses.
Yeah!
having a little fun, you big grump.
Well, there it is. How are we going to get it free?
A push. But trust me. Ready. Dig in and push with everything.
Yes, sir. How do we get down?
We jump.
Really?
Come. Do not panic!
Why would I panic?
Whoa. I have you!
You're cracked, you know that?
Well. Good. We should keep moving.
The chisel tip!
Give the man credit. He has a talent for destroying things.
Remember that head.
Never leaves my mind.
Those were the guys we saw with Baldur. His nephews?
Aye. Magni and Modi. The sons of Thor.
Mother always said the Aesir were the worst of gods. And Thor was the worst of the Aesir. Guess he's a terrible father, too.
They are no longer children. They have no excuse.
Will Sindri be okay?
They'll never even see him. Ah, the great dining hall. Envy of all Midgard. Funny, I remember there being a massive candelabrum. Really livened up the place.
This is locked up good.
Ah, yes. You can't help but break things, can you? If memory serves, the Jarl's throne was just on the other side of that wall of ice.
No way to reach it.
Yeah!
something ahead.
See, lad, he's fine.
Thought it best to vanish when Thor's idiot sons showed up.
Hey, Sindri, could you take a look at this?
Honestly? I don't have much else going on right now.
Will you focus on your damn... You quit that shit. I mean it. He went to war with Uncle and walked away. Maybe. Uncle hadn't seen straight in years. As long as father believes him, I'm so believing him. So we will stop talking. Focus.
The travelers. Oh, disgusting. Smelly, covered in God knows how many little beasties, but gorgeous armor. Let's see if I can't make something more sanitary. Yes? Ready and ready. Who knew? That looks amazing. The secret to any craft is in the fine detail. Was there... More to discuss?
Hurry, brother. We may get a piece of the chisel and be gone before they even notice.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Boy.
Surrender. The old father demands it.
No. This fight is mine, boy. Go!
And where do you think you're going? Oh no, brother! The little freak's got a bow! What are we gonna do? Don't tell me!
Us. What does Odin want?
Oh no, don't get me. Come here, you're done.
Shut up! Don't call me that!
Stay behind me, boy. Why do you hunt us? What does Odin want?
Oh no, don't care. Come here, you're done for, that is it.
Shut up! Don't call me that!
Yeah! Can't believe you lied to this man. Skinny little dogs can barely lift the tongue.
I said shut up!
Calm yourself, boy.
Having fun yet? It's
up,
assholes.
Yeah!
Shut it out! Focus!
Father would be so disappointed.
Small one, you are.
Don't tell me what to do.
Your mother other yourself. She cut up your face if you do about her.
Don't talk about my mother!
Don't talk about my mommy.
You're listening to him, lad. Trying to rile you up.
Idiot!
The sons of Thor are welcome to try.
Head!
Sorry, overstepped, yeah?
Gonna drag your carcass to us!
It's a boss, hoax.
It's a little rust.
Stop it!
Boy, stay focused.
How could you?
The boy's sick, he needs Freya.
No!
Steady.
I'll be all right.
There you go, lad.
I'm fine, see?
We should keep an eye on him.
enough?
Should do. With that, we can carve the travel rune to Jotunheim. Get you where you need to go. Oh, incidentally, all those magically sealed doors we've seen can now be unlocked. Like that one round the corner. You can get through that door there now that you've got the chisel. That he did.
He was a god. But you killed him.
Minor Aesir, perhaps. But I.
And his father is Thor.
Not minor. Not minor at all, him. This will not go over well in Asgard.
I defended us. Nothing more. I fear no judgment.
Judgment, no. But if vengeance is any concern.
Since when can you kill a god?
Found anything good in Fafnir's storeroom? Like, maybe...
Wait,
a whetstone?
Which way back?
Hey! Did you hear? Magni, the Aesir god, son of Thor, dead! I know! Now Modi's on a rampage across Midgard, looking for the killer, swearing that once he finds him, he'll... Oh, shit, that was you guys.
We should probably discuss that more quietly.
Or not at all. I think that's a great plan. Found anything good in Fafnir's storeroom? Like, maybe a whetstone?
I don't think the lad's doing too well.
I'm fine.
If so, then keep up.
Yes, sir.
Magni didn't come back to life.
That is interesting. It's known the Aesir find their own way to Valhalla. No Valkyrie escort, no processing at the gates of Helheim. That may be significant.
Giant's hand.
What? What is this place?
Fishermen would bring the day's catch into this port and use that contraption to send some of it directly to the Jarl's main kitchen. The rest were sorted and sold.
There is an exit under the thumb. Find a way across. There's an opening.
I can get it. There's a path to the exit on the other side.
There's a rope up here.
Under his palm. We're almost there.
Everything we just did. Climbed around a dead giant, rode a giant falling hammer, fought some bad gods. What do you think Mother would say?
Bet you have come a long way.
Thanks. I see something over there.
Here, boy. Another one.
Ah, you know this one, don't you?
It's Thamel, the giant stonemason. Is he building a wall around Jotunheim?
It was to be his masterwork. He only wanted to protect his people.
Too bad the first part got burned.
I prefer the last panel was burned. Such a senseless pity.
Like a prison.
That would explain the hefty magical lock on the outside.
But it's more than that. I have this feeling like something is waiting for us down here.
You've a knack for ominous statements, lad.
What kind of something?
I'm not sure. Something powerful.
Whatever you feel, boy, we will handle it. We have come this far, yes?
Yes, Father.